The regional police spokesperson of North Kyoga, Jimmy Patrick Okema, says numerous complaints have been filed by residents about the disorganized streets. However, he has faulted the city council for neglecting their work.
As police, we get a lot of concern from members of the public about Lira City itself being so disorganized. And we believe people think this is really work of police. Some people call this vehicle as parked wrongly, this vehicle has done what. But we want members of the public to understand that as security, our work is to enforce. When you look at a city or urban settings, there are always the management of these places. For example, if it is Lira City, we have a Lira City management team.
In defense, the city mayor Sam Atul, however, says organization of roads and traffic flow is work meant for police traffic department, not the city council. He has advised police not to abdicate their work.
The issue of road use in this country lies with the traffic police. If there's any double parking, if there's any misuse of the road, the police traffic have to take the matter as it is written in the law to deal with those road offenders because they are interfering with traffic. I don't believe that the city council should again go to regulate traffic in the city.
Okema says the city council collects revenue and issues parking tickets. He has therefore asked the council to take on the role of organizing the streets.
When we talk about parking, there are people who issue tickets to vehicles that pass along the street. It is not police. It is people, not police. Let's look at border stages. These are people who pay revenue to the council or to the city. It is not police who issue those things. So it's a matter of amnesizing. We feel that this is disconcern from members of the public. It is real. And you yourself, if you move to town, you will realize that. And even now, when you move, you notice when you go, you want to park, you do not have where you are supposed to park to find a vendor to put these tomatoes.
According to the mayor, the city leadership is working to reorganize the city by zoning businesses.
On the issue of zoning of businesses, that is a process that as council, we are committed to it. It's not going to happen overnight, but we are working on the process of zoning of businesses within the city.
He also points out that they are working towards getting street vendors off the streets.
Budgets, you use council authorization. So we are committed to that. Using the word Lira is disorganized. Oh, it's a pity. It's a pity.
Meanwhile, a night watchman has been confirmed dead after the collapse of a building. Sources say part of the Blue Valley Guest House, located on Oro Road, collapsed at around 2 a.m. and crushed one Godfrey Otui to death. Police and rescue services reached the scene to help retrieve the body. However, colleagues of the deceased did not give rescue services a chance as they tirelessly dug to retrieve the body.
The house collapsed on him, and this is a guy who has been here with us for all this time. He's a guy of 35 years old. He's from Minakulo, that is Oyam district. My appeal to the ghetto community and the ghetto youth, I'm just advising, let's try to take cautions over some buildings where we take our shelter in. We should try to avoid to stay in some building which are collapsing, like this building, it has overstayed here.
I got him as a washing bay. He has been helping me as a security guard here and a washing bay. He has been sleeping here. He's a ghetto, you know, ghetto people.
Police took the body to Lira Regional Referral Hospital pending postmortem, while the owner of the house, Richard Olila, a businessman, was arrested and taken to Lira Central Police Station.